As the cost of living continues to rise, thousands of women are finding a new way to make money. Their chosen profession is controversial. But in 21st century Britain, what is it really like to be a stripper?
You get called slappers, prostitutes, sluts, every word in the dictionary.
We love the funny butter!
With the number of British strip clubs having doubled in the last 10 years.
Tits all over the place, hold fire.
This series is filmed over the course of 5 months in Scotland's three largest cities.
You've got strippers here, you've got strippers there, you've got strippers everywhere.
Meeting the girls trying to juggle love, life, and lap dancing.
All they care about is your fucking money. That's all they give a shit about.
And revealing the reality behind the fantasy.
We're not fucking robots, do you know what I mean? We have feelings, we're just normal people.
It's like a madhouse.
This episode follows the strippers working in Aberdeen.
To Aberdeen?
Yes.
Scotland's wealthiest city, built on black gold.
You can make a grand in a night.
But in this boom town, how do the girls cope with the increased demands of the job?
You appreciate just quiet and nothingness.
I couldn't get through one shift without a couple of drinks in me.
And when the work dries up, what do you do next?
It's not milfs anymore, it's gilfs.
They can screw their job, they can actually shove up their arse. Just tired of the dance life now.
Aberdeen, the centre of the oil industry in Europe. Outside London, it is home to more multi-millionaires per square mile than any city in the UK.
This is Aberdeen.
Aberdeen, it's a very affluent area, very, very affluent area.
The oil capital of Europe, this is the place where the streets are paved with gold.
But oil is not the only industry thriving in Aberdeen. Out of 15 nightclubs across the city, 6 are strip joints, attracting lap dancers from all over the world. Two girls who travel the globe with the aim of making big money are 28-year-old Danny and 27-year-old Zena.
Dancing tourism,
yes,
you can call it that.
We're slowly stripping our way around the world.
These girls see stripping as nothing more than a business.
I like to think that I'm using this job as an opportunity to put myself into the future that I want. You know, it allows me to do things. It's taught me a lot of transferable skills.
It's like a stepping stone, and just so many opportunities come from it as well.
But for me, the job is just the job and that's it, and there's nothing more.
Lap dancers often earn more than £1,000 a week.
You go to work,
exactly,
you do your job, you come home, you count your money.
Yeah, that's the best.
Spend your money
and
go make some more money.
And we live a good lifestyle.
Doing this job, you don't exactly get a pension either, so you have to make sure you've got your own back.
Stripping on tour allows Danny and Zena to go where the money is good and make as much as they can as quickly as possible.
You know, the guys that have been on the rigs for 2 weeks, with a bike to go on the rigs for 2 weeks.
You've essentially got a captive audience there, which is...
It's good.
Yeah.
So who's in control?
Good question.
It is a good question.
That is
a...
I wish I knew the answer. I think what it actually is
really, is we think we're in control and the customer thinks they're in control.
We like to think we're in control, they like to think they're in control. It's a mutual exploitation where we're both exploiting each other's side of things.
Oh yeah, because, yeah, so, you know, this is the thing about us girls being exploited. Well, really, who's being exploited here? Us or the men? You know, their wallets.
But in order to manipulate their wallets, the dancers need customers. And there's no shortage of them in Aberdeen.
Oh, you have every type of guy coming here. You have every type. You have people like myself. The girls are like friends. You've got the other people that come in just to get away from the clubbing and the nightlife. And then you have the other... You have the customers that think they can have what they want.
I think different guys get different things.
Yeah, some people like to sit and talk. Some people like, you know, to connect with someone and have conversation. Some people just like to see tits.
Do you have a girlfriend?
Yes.
And does she know that you come to these clubs?
Now she does.
Are you single at the moment?
I am single.
So have you been in these clubs when you've had a partner? Or?
Have I been in these clubs with a partner? Never.
Don't you think it's cheating?
No. When you go downtown, here's an analogy. You go downtown, you look in the shop, you look at it, you really want it, but you know you can't have it. So it's a similar thing, eh? You look at it, you let the lady dance with you, but you know you can't have it. So no, it's not really cheating, is it?
One of the local women working in Aberdeen is Vicky.
And what, you know, when you've got guys who are married or girlfriend, do you ever feel guilty?
I don't feel guilty, I feel sorry for them. And I think the only reason they've come here is because they can't speak to their wives or girlfriends. You know, I've had guys crying on my shoulder saying, my wife's sleeping with my best mate. And I had snot coming down my arm and you're just like, getting paid 50 quid for this. It's great.
At only 19, Vicky has already been stripping for over a year.
The amount of mascaras I have.
How did you get into it?
Because I was in a bad relationship when I first started. He was really controlling and possessive and manipulative. So it was kind of like, do this and get a job or I'm going to chuck you out. Get a job, or I'm gonna beat you up. Get a job, or you're gonna die. So, and I saw a job on Gumtree where they needed dancers, and I've danced most of my life, you know. So it was kind of like, get a job. And got the job, and started making money, and he would obviously think it was his money, so he would take it all.
I'm trying to like show like my family to like anyone on TV. I think they've seen enough while I'm working here.
Vicky managed to escape from the relationship but continues to strip. She works in Private Eyes, one of Aberdeen's top lap dancing clubs. All the girls are expected to take their turn on the pole and approach men for private dances.
First lap dance for the 65-year-old, and I hated every moment of it. It was creepy, it was scary, it was disgusting, it was disturbing.
As a young woman, Vicky finds the job difficult and often turns to drink to help her cope.
You start drinking and your confidence just goes up. There's nothing there holding you back from doing what you're doing in this job when you're drinking.
Duncan, can I get a bigger glass?
I think it's just like, it's a habit.
It's like a madhouse.
So why do you strip?
I think it's kind of an escape from my past. You know, I'm not really who I am. I'm Vicky in here. You know, it's an escape. I can be whoever I want, I can make up whatever I want, and these people will believe it.
Growing up, Vicky was very different to her stripper persona.
I am a tomboy, you know, I play Xbox and I play computer games. You know, I had two older brothers.
Could you have imagined when you're a little girl that you'd be working in a strip club?
No, I never. You know, I always thought I'd be somewhere outside Aberdeen doing, you know, my college or university by now, but, you know, Mum and Dad still can't believe it, you know. I'm their baby. You know, Mum's just kind of like, my dad's like.
And has dancing changed you as a person?
It's gave me more confidence. You know, I was in a bad relationship and I thought, you know, no one would want me. But it gave me a lot of confidence. So I'd have people come up to me and go, you know, you are beautiful, you shouldn't be doing this job. And it does, it makes you feel a lot happier.
Do you think it makes you happier just on the surface, or does it make you happy deep down?
On the surface, you know. Deep down, I would love to get out of it, but it's an addiction, you know. It is a very hard industry to get out of. I do find it sad, you know, when I see, like, the 30 and the 40-year-olds doing it, and they've got the kids, and it does make you actually wonder if that's going to be me in like 20 years time. I don't want that, you know. Don't really want to be the old stripper.
Known as the happiest place in Scotland, Aberdeen is home to 6 lap dancing clubs. With a thriving oil business, Aberdeen's economy is booming.
I don't think the recession has hit here like it's hit other parts. It's like a small gold mine, you know. And, you know, I know a lot of younger guys in their 20s, you know, making serious money.
All this money means that the city's strip clubs are some of the busiest in the country. For Private Eye's head doorman Butch, the nights are always eventful.
Well, on a regular door, you know, there'd maybe be fighting, there'd be assaults, there'd be people trying to fight with myself or other door staff. Here we'll have customers that'll try and get too hands-on with the girls, and we'll have to deal with them appropriately. Sometimes possibly the guys want to get nude, you know, and take the willies out, but we'll just get rid of them as necessary, you know, stop their indecent exposure. The girls can handle themselves, you know. Sometimes I'm not even needed. Sometimes I'll go in and the guy said, I'm leaving. He doesn't want to take on a sea of angry girls.
Inside the club, touring strippers Danny and Zena are taking advantage of what the city has to offer. The girls are in the industry for the money, but taking their clothes off hasn't always been easy.
I've always been very comfortable with my body.
I wasn't at all. I had so many issues.
Stripper with issues.
#issues. Like, if you'd have said to me,
if you'd have said to me that
we went to school together.
Yeah, we've known each other for about 17 years.
Yeah, yeah.
But if someone had said to me at school,
I can't believe how much it's changed me, actually. It really has. It's done me so much. It really has, in comparison to who I was or how I was and how I've grown as a person. It's made such a difference to me, and my life, the whole trajectory of my life has changed so much for the better.
One of the advantages of stripping on tour is the chance to explore the local surroundings.
It's got a lot of history, hasn't it? Yeah.
On their days off, Danny and Zena enjoy taking in the sights of each city they visit.
Oh, look.
Oh, no way!
Oh. Oh my God! We have to go in, I'm so excited.
To Aberdeen.
Yes.
For the girls, stripping provides opportunities that they feel they wouldn't find in other jobs.
Sometimes people say, oh, what are you going to do when you're older? You know, when are you going to get a real job and things like that? It's like, but I have got a real job.
It is a real job.
Yeah, it's a real job. You have to be committed to it. You have to get up and go to work.
Yeah.
I just think, actually, what people mean is, when are you going to get a more socially acceptable job?
When are you going to do the same thing as everyone else?
When are you going to do the same as everyone else? When are you going to be tied into the office hours, to the having to ask for leave, having to...
Don't get me wrong, that suits some people, but for me it
doesn't. Oh, God, yeah,
me.
Yeah, no.
Some people, each to their own. So it's okay. Yeah. The thing is, it's about choice, isn't it? That's the thing.
Danny has just completed her MA in art.
I don't think feasibly I could do a 9 to 5, earning sort of minimum wage per hour.
Yeah.
And be able to fit in my art as well and make that a priority in order to work for that kind of future that I want.
And when would I travel?
When would you travel if you had that?
When would I travel?
Because you wouldn't be able to afford it for a start.
Yeah, correct, yeah.
Thank you.
In their continued pursuit of their ambitions, Danny and Zena will soon be moving on from Aberdeen.
Should we skip? Should we continue to skip?
Lap dancing can be a short-lived career, with the majority of strippers quitting by the age of 29. But when their dancing careers are over, some girls find it hard to leave the adult entertainment industry and branch into more risque areas of the business.
There, Mr. Papa Wiggle. Don't worry, darling, I remembered you. You wanted a lovely little video of me wearing my bright pink neon stockings. So, darling, I have put them on for you.
Ex-stripper Jodie used to work at Private Eyes. 5 years ago, she was diagnosed with hypermobility in her knees, putting an abrupt end to her lap dancing career.
That's enough of that. I mean, you're a stripper, you're getting naked, you're an exhibitionist, you enjoy it, you love all the attention and all that. And maybe you're like me, you can't do it anymore because your body. Knees are fucked up. Or this, that, the next thing, X, Y, and Z, you don't want to do stripping anymore. The natural progression is to sort of swing into porn.
Determined to continue using her looks to make a living, Jodie has set up an online business from the comfort of her own home, under her work alias, Jamie TT.
The webcam industry is quite easy, actually. You just get a computer, a microphone, a webcam, has to be a decent one, good internet connection. I've got fibre optic here. And you just plug yourself in. As long as you know the websites to go on, there's so many websites out there. And once you sign up, put your IDs across, because you need to make sure you're legal, so you can start working within days. And the paychecks come in every week. Every week. So you can't complain at that, you know. Not at all. And guess what I've got on, darling? Let me take you down here. What would you like to do, you naughty boy? You guys having a naughty afternoon? Hey, Tom. Hey, Alan. You know I love my naughty boys.
Before her knees packed in, Jodie spent 8 years stripping, 5 days a week, 7 hours a night.
I mean, I've done my time of sitting on people's laps and grinding and all that, dancing up and down a pole. I've done that. I earn more doing this than a stripper would make now. But then it is more explicit. What you're doing is taking it further than what you would do in a strip bar. Shall I get a bit naughty for you, darling? Should I do it, baby?
How long do you plan to do this for?
However long I can, you know. As long as the face is good, as long as the body's all right, and as long as I can still talk the talk, I will still make money on this. Imagine me with you right now. You want me to squirt, don't you, sweetheart? You want me to get my legs spread wide.
What about sex? Does it affect how you feel about sex?
Well, I don't get sex. The last time I had sex was about 2012. So, I mean, yeah, I mean, it does with me, because obviously I don't have a partner. I don't have a fuck buddy. I'm not that sort of person that will go into town prowling for a man. That's just not me. And I don't use escorts. So what's left? That's what's left. This is my boy. So yeah, it does skew your way of sex. I mean, obviously, because this is all sexually orientated. So when you finish work, the last thing you sort of want to do is have sex.
Is it something that you'd want? Do you want to find a partner that you can share your life?
Eventually. I mean, it would be nice to have the partner. You can go all together. You can plan yourself. You plan your life together with them. Eventually, I would like to find someone, but it's finding the prince out of all the frogs. There's a lot of frogs in Aberdeen.
It's halfway through Vicky's Friday night shift at Private Eyes, and it's another night of drinking. Club's manager is Raymond.
Rock on, baby. Right.
He spends most of his time keeping an eye on the girls.
Watching you all.
Yes!
My friend said, God, you've landed it lucky. If only they knew. When it comes to managing the girls, sometimes I feel like a teacher in a classroom. The girls, the hard work, each and every one of them, you have to handle in a different way, you know.
She is up there and she's giving it to you.
As the night goes on, so does Vicky's drinking.
Put your hands together for the beautiful Vicky.
When they've been drinking, they seem to forget where they are, what they're doing, and they just get a wee bit over the top.
When a stag show gets out of control, it all gets too much for Raymond.
Vicky, nicely.
He's forced to have a word with Vicky.
What's happened?
Steve, they're actually so, actually upset. They would actually give a fucking fuck. But they don't, all they care about is their fucking money. And what they make, that's all they give a shit about. Don't care about the girls who are upset or unhappy. I hate it here. I hate my passion.
Overhearing Vicky's protests backstage, Raymond decides that enough is enough.
I've been fighting for Private Eyes one before about being drunk when I'm not. Honestly, when we're upset and we want to talk about stuff, they send us home because we're drunk. And they don't take it into themselves that we're actually physically upset. That's what they see us as drunk. If we're not, yeah, we have a few glasses of champagne, a few shots, but that's it. They can screw their job. They can actually shove it up their arse. I'm done. I'm sick of it.
Unfortunately, she's been warned on umpteen occasions. We've let her off so many times, and tonight was just the last straw. We just had to let her go. The danger is they're not in control of what they're doing, what they're saying. It causes problems with customers. They can tend to get a bit aggressive. As you can see with Vicky, she gets very emotional, crying, wanting this, wanting that. I think this is when you see the younger side of the girl. They don't seem to handle it very well, you know?
You're meant to get drunk. You're meant to have a good time. Just just tired of the dance life now.
And is that it for Vicky?
I'm afraid so.
Aberdeen is Scotland's third largest city. But with a population of only 220,000, it has more strip clubs per head than any other city in the UK. A lot of debate has surrounded lap dancing clubs since they first opened in the UK in 1995, with the girls facing negativity on a daily basis.
We get called slappers, prostitutes, sluts.
You're a stripper.
It's seen as a negative thing.
Failed to notice our sparkling personalities, don't they? We're in the disgusting box.
We have morals, we have respect for our body. I'm not going to let some 75-year-old man take me around the back and do me doggy style, am I? No.
To be honest, I find it just boring now. Give it a rest.
If you had a daughter, how would you feel about her doing this?
I probably wouldn't mind because there's nothing bad about it. I don't think I would like her dancing in my club.
The man behind Private Eyes is Tony Cochran, who owns four of the 20 lap dancing clubs in Scotland.
If your husband or boyfriend is out, then it's the best place to send him because you can send him to a nightclub for a night out with his friends. And there's a great danger he'll be buying girls drinks and flirting and getting numbers and possibly going home with someone. Come to a strip club or a lap dance gentleman's club and your husband or boyfriend will be totally safe because he's coming here for it's just a fantasy experience. It's a fantasy and they come home, if anything, they'll come home and the wives and girlfriends will enjoy the evening even more when they come home.
So are you a marriage wrecker or a marriage saver?
I think we're a marriage saver, I would say.
A few days ago, lap dancer Vicky was fired from Private Eyes for drinking too much.
I was angry, upset. I was drunk. I can put my hands up to that, and I am really sorry for being drunk. I had to drink to work here. I couldn't get through one shift without a couple of drinks in me.
After numerous discussions with Tony, she's managed to persuade him to give her a second chance at his other club, Private Eyes 2.
So why were you so desperate to go back?
Because we get used to the compliments, the money, the atmosphere, it's all that. Still earning a living, still making my own way through, making money to pay for rent, food and fags.
Tonight, she's shopping for a new outfit for her first shift back.
Are you wearing them quite high?
Yeah.
I've got this one's here, black, 6-inch. What do you think? Okay.
They're not high enough.
7-inch.
Oh, they're pretty.
I could totally do some damage to some guys with that.
They going on easy enough?
Ta-da! I'm ready for work.
But club owner Tony still has to break the news to manager Raymond.
How we doing?
The Wanderer returns.
Aye.
I've had like a text every day and then a call. I had a good chat with her. Mm. And she swore blind that I'll be water from now on, no more alcohol. And
but then we've done that on umpteen occasions.
I know. Look, we'll give her a chance. I mean, so we're going to put her into number two, so take her away from the situation here. Put her into two and then we'll...
She's a young drink girl. She's got to grow up.
She did apologise and she was kind of full of remorse and she says, look, it was kind of really silly. And so she was the one that made a suggestion she wouldn't drink anymore. Mm. So I says, that's fine. So on the good side, we're going to get her sober. On the downside, we'll be about £1,000 a week down on the bar. So that's one of those things.
My ass.
With her first night back looming, Vicky has asked her friend Lilly, one of the club's best dancers, to teach her some new pole tricks.
Just lift up and hold yourself here. It's really all about your arms. And then when you're at the top, you can just clamp yourself with your legs like that and then do whatever you want to do from there. And then just to get yourself back down, just swing. Just swing. Mm-hmm. Or just try and keep your legs straight though. Just pull it, it's all about your arms, babe. Yeah, it's very difficult. No.
It's exhausting. It mentally and physically exhausts you out.
Keep that straight. And you move right down the floor. But that's nice.
Guys don't understand how hard it is for us, you know, to actually do this job. They just see us as toys and meat.
And remember, this leg is going straight. Dancing. Yeah. It's something that I always wanted to do when I was younger, babe. Yeah. When I was about 15, 16, I always wanted to do it. And it was the pole more than anything.
Yeah.
You know, I always wanted to be able to pole dance.
Does your friends and family know?
Yeah, everyone knows. I'm very honest about it. I don't think there's any point in lying. Because at the end of the day, you're going to have someone that's going to put up a picture. Or yeah. I've been in situations where I've danced for, like, school teachers and stuff. You know?
I've done that.
Yeah, but they've not even really known until afterwards. And I would be like, I would say the name and they'd be mortified, you know. So, but it's quite funny.
Unlike Vicky, who fell into stripping, Lilly has always dreamt of making a name for herself in the adult industry.
I would love to do lads mags, glamour modelling. I remember even being 14 and always wanting to do that, you know, like looking in the paper and seeing like the page three girls. I always wanted to do things like that, but I never thought that I would be able to. And I thought stripping was a way to get into it. I was adamant.
She moved from her native Newcastle to Aberdeen 3 years ago for the stripping opportunities the city provides. Lilly takes her job very seriously.
This one looks nice in the club because it lights up. Same with the pink, they light up like neon. I love the blue. This looks really nice on, so this little skirt that we have here. I've got these little knickers which are like bottomless. So this is the bum. You'll see the bum. The one piece, which is quite nice. It's really pretty on.
Is it important to keep the two separate in terms of your work underwear and your normal underwear?
For some people, probably. Some people, for example, I wouldn't wear these today, just lounging around, you know? I'd like something like, I'm wearing something like this right now in pink. They're really comfy. Really comfy. Yeah.
Lap dancers work an average of 7 hours a night, with most doing at least 4 or 5 shifts a week.
Do you think people, or men who come into the club, think about this side of you?
No, probably not. Definitely not. No. I don't think the picture is in a onesie at all.
What do you think they think you get up to in your spare time?
Probably think I'm always out wearing next and out, dancing, having a drink, going wild, partying.
Is that the case?
No, I like just chilling out. We do that all at work, you know what I mean? It's like, it is like a night out at work, so you appreciate so much more just quiet and nothingness.
For strippers, life away from the club is hardly a 24-hour party.
When I'm not at work, don't want to do my hair, I want to sit in my onesie.
I will sit in my onesie.
And watch Hollyoaks.
Take away in front of the telly in my onesie.
Probably not shower for 2 days and play PlayStation.
I hate wearing makeup in the day because you have to put so much on
yeah.
while you're working.
In fact,
I think guys are probably really disappointed because they expect, you know, this stripper and wild kind of...
They expect you to be in the stripper role all the time.
They think I'm a sex animal, that I'm mental in bed, that they would get a fucking passionate night, and it's a load of BS. It is absolute crap.
Having cashed in on Aberdeen's wealth,
hello.
Hiya.
It's time for Danny and Zina to move on.
Aberdeen. I like it. I think I'll definitely come back again.
Financially, it's been worth coming up.
I think the good thing about going away is that you look forward to coming back. Sometimes, yeah. Like, obviously, when you're away, you miss your friends and your family. Like, I miss my mum and dad when I'm not about. I think it can be tiring, especially when it's a tester week.
And we've ended up staying in three places in a week, and that, you
three
know,
places, four different clubs that we've tried out, and it's...
Yeah. So where to next then? That's the big question.
Well, at some point I'd like to go to Cardiff.
Maybe Vienna, Paris. Really need to look into New York, Australia.
It's quite a list we're racking up, isn't it?
Although a future in stripping can be uncertain, it's something that the girls have learnt to accept.
I fully believe that the universe will provide whatever I need. I don't worry because, you know, 4 years ago, I wouldn't have thought I'd have been in Aberdeen working as a dancer.
And the thing is, though, doing this job, it gives you that attitude that you can go out and you can do... If you put your mind to it, you can do things. You know, if you want something, you work for it. But for now, I think I'm going to go back down to the studio. Crack on with my artwork because I've got a lot to be catching up on.
Thank you very much. Have a good day.
Although Danny has always enjoyed dancing, she hopes that one day she can focus on her art full time.
Do you think it'll be hard to give up the stripping?
I think the lifestyle.
I think
is
once
addictive.
You're in, it's
difficult to
have
because you get used to having such freedom. Some people can come to work and, you know, they hate it, they hate they shouldn't be doing it if that's the case.
Mm.
You know, you
shouldn't be a dancer because you have to be.
Yeah, yeah. The moment I start disliking this job is the moment I'll stop.
It's been over a week since Vicky was fired from Private Eyes. Tonight is her first shift back.
Hello.
Hello. How are you?
Nice to see you, baby.
She'll be working alongside her friend, Lilly.
Are you happy to be back?
Yes.
God.
I'm very happy.
Has it been busy?
Yeah. I know.
Is it busy on the side?
The weekends. I found the weekends too. I've been making more money on a Monday.
Really?
Yeah. Like last
I'm working
week,
on a Monday.
Last weekend wasn't very good, but I think tonight will be good because it's always the weekend after pay weekends better, I think.
That's a lovely collaboration.
Do you want some Jimmy Choo?
I love some Jimmy Choo.
I swear to you.
Why are you?
Aberdeen strip clubs offer girls what seems like easy money, but it's a tough industry where you are judged on both looks and personality.
It's not easy. It's hard because you need to be very strong and you can't let a negative comment bring you down. I'm quite happy with my body now, but it can make some people insecure. We're all walking around half naked. And you do compare your body. You always want what you don't have, don't you? Like, I always want bigger boobs or to be more curvy or whatever.
Some strippers develop a character for work far removed from their real personality.
Some girls have separate names, some girls have like three or four different names they go by, they keep changing it just because they can, you know, and they want to keep their work life and their realities completely separate.
Vicky's real name is Christy.
I'm sure I like skinned my knees off someone's fucking jeans.
During her leave from the club, Christy has enjoyed spending time with her new boyfriend away from her stripper persona.
Just relaxing, chilling, being not Vicky, being Christy. You know, eating junk food with a boyfriend, watching zombies, killing zombies on Xbox and the PS. So it was nice. It's relaxing to be just me.
She's starting to wonder if stripping is really for her.
I might go back to college this year, hopefully. Do the rest of my HND business course. So get the business side of the world. And not stay a stripper for much longer.
You done?
One in four girls who strip are doing so in order to fund their education. 28-year-old Danny has used lap dancing to help her complete her MA in art. The job hasn't only paid for her degree, it has also inspired her work.
Painting does have personality due to the expression, you know, it's a very intense expression. It's not just objectified, she's sort of challenging almost with her gaze and she's saying, you know, you're not going to see this unless you pay for it. Which kind of relates to the work that I do outside of my art.
Today, Danny is in London exhibiting some of her paintings.
Doing what I do is very inspiring to the work I create. It allows me to create something that's interesting to me anyway.
What would you say to those people who disagree with your stripping?
I use my job as a way of supporting myself as an artist. There's not many of the jobs, realistically, that I feel that I could do where I could have such a good balance of working and creating. It got me through my education, for Christ's sake. You know, no one's twisting my arm to do the job. You know, I'm using the job proactively. I feel it's an empowering thing because of the things it's allowed me to do.
Are you?
Best friend and fellow stripper Zina has flown in from Copenhagen to support Danny.
Look at you, extremity.
Can you see the likeness?
I can see the likeness.
Aww. Do you like it?
I am. I'm very proud. Very proud of you indeed. She's worked so hard the last few years and now she's getting her exhibitions and she's getting her work out there and people are talking about it, and that I just think that's brilliant. This is her future, and again, it's all been done through dancing. And here she is now. So it just goes to show that strippers aren't stupid. You do whatever you want.
My end result will hopefully be a full-time artist. So I've got no regrets about being a dancer because it's just part of the journey to getting me where I want to be. I don't think, although there probably is a niche market for it, I don't think I'll be a stripper when I'm 60. You know.
Many girls use lap dancing as a stepping stone into a different career. 21-year-old Lilly is using stripping as a way into glamour modelling.
I just don't want to be working in a club after 25. I've always said I only want to do it for like 5 years, no longer. So that's my aim.
Do you think there's a shelf life for dancers?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I couldn't tell you an age though, because some women look great that are older and they still make really good money. As long as you're not dancing when you're like 50 odd, then it's fine.
Today, Lilly has a test shoot with a local photographer in the hope of getting noticed by an agency.
Thank you.
It's nerve-wracking, but it's exciting. Yeah, it's good fun.
Can you see yourself doing this?
Yeah, definitely. I love it. Just want to get better and better at it and progress. This bit?
Yeah.
Do you think you'll carry on dancing as well as modelling?
It depends how it goes, really. I wouldn't like to.
Would you miss dancing?
No.
Why not?
Because I think this is a much better job. If I was doing this, I wouldn't miss dancing.
Do you mind using your body to make money?
No. It's what God give you, innit? Use it.
If you've got it.
Flaunt it. I do.
Is this just the beginning, Lily?
Yeah, this is just the beginning. Watch this space.
Support for the issues raised can be found at channel4.com/support. Well, next week, Dr. Christian Jessen investigates controversial therapies that treat homosexuality as a curable illness. How? By going undercover and taking them himself. That's next Tuesday night at 10. On the way, Channel 4 goes to the bogs with a look inside the nightclub toilet.